Handicapper Steve here, handicapping the racing from Punchestown Racecourse here on Saturday. It is May the 4th, 2019. It's the final day of the Punchestown Festival, and I'm going to look at almost all the races on the program. But before I get on to that, remember to please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5 for more selections for race courses around the world, and also check out my Kentucky Derby preview video and my 2000 Guineas preview video, and also join me next week for the May Festival from Chester, one of my favorite festivals of the year in the UK. Great races there. Also, join me next weekend for the French 1,000 and 2,000 guineas from Longchamp next Sunday. That looks like an excellent race, and I think the best three-year-old in Europe is running that day. Who is it? You just have to join me next week for my preview and selections here on YouTube to figure out who it is, but you might know. But let's get to today's action from Punchestown. We're going to look at almost all the races except the final two. We're not going to look at the 7th race or the 8th race, because those are two races that I just have no idea with, and I'll just watch them as a fan. So let's get on to it. We're going to look at the first 6 races. The first race goes off at 2:35 today, not the regular 3:40 post time like it was all week, but 2:35, the first race from Punchestown. It's Dooley Insurance Group Cross Country Chase. It's a cross country chase going for purse $17,500. Race for 5-year-olds and upwards, field of 10 horses, going 3 miles and 1/8 over the chase course. My top selection here, I'm going to go to the 7 horse Hurricane Darwin. I'm going to go 7-2 in the forecast exacta. 7-2 forecast exacta. Top selection 7 horse Hurricane Darwin. 9-year-old gelding by Westerner. Donna Mailer gets the leg up for Alan Fleming. The horse's most recent outing came the 10th of February here at Punchestown, 3 miles 1/8 in a cross country chase. Same distance, same course as today. He finished 2nd by 2 lengths behind Josie's Order. He jumped well, had a decent turn of foot. He ran quite well there off the break. Before that, the 18th of November here at Punchestown, on very, very firm ground. 3 miles in a cross country. He didn't finish. He fell, you know, first off the break. Firm ground. It just wasn't setting up for him. It wasn't the day to win. And then at Punchestown on soft ground last April, 3 miles in a cross country. He finished 2nd by 8.5 lengths. He jumped well, but Josie's Order just got to him. Josie's Order is 7-5 here and running back in this one. I backed him earlier in the week on Tuesday, or excuse me, on Saturday, or whatever the fucking day it was, 2 days ago. It was Thursday. There we go. Sorry, my brain's fried all this week from all these previews I'm doing. But, you know, he ran Tuesday, backed him there, high weight. He just didn't really get a good kick. But, you know, and I don't think he's going to run well here today. But, you know, this horse, he just got the other side of, you know, just couldn't get in front of Josie's Orders. But I think today they're going to switch it around. I think Hurricane Darwin has a better weight, and I think he's come to this race a lot better, and I think he get a piece of it. You know, if you look at his races, you know, he always runs good races, then he'll always throw in those clunkers where he'll fall or pull up, like at Cheltenham in 2018 in the cross country, but then he ran here in February of 2018 in a cross country. He ran 4th decently, and then he threw in a clunker at Navan in November of 2017, but I think he's sitting on a good race, a little bit of a refreshing. He should be fresh enough to win, and I think he can get at a 4-1. I'll take the chance with him. So to recap my selection for the first from Punchestown, the 2:35, it's Dooley Insurance Group Cross Country Chase. Let's go to the 7 horse Hurricane Darwin. I'll go 7-2 in the forecast exacta. Let's get to the second. The 3:10, the second race from Punchestown, it is the Boyle Sports Handicap Chase. It's a handicap chase going for a purse of $57,500. Races for 5-year-olds and upwards. Horses rate 0 to 145. Field of 18 horses going 3 miles and 7/8 over the chase course. They'll be staying quite a bit in this one. My top selection, I'm going to go to the number 2 horse, Manila Awards. Going to go 2-8 in the forecast exacta. 2-8 forecast exacta. Top selection 2 horse Manila Rewards. Robbie Powers on this one for Harry Fry, this 8-year-old gelding by Oscar. The horse's most recent outing came the 17th of November at Cheltenham, 3 miles in a novice chase. He finished 4th by 5.25 lengths there, and he just never got into it. He never weakened out of it, but he never quickened out of it either. He just kind of stayed. I think, you know, coming up to the longer trip today, I think he'll stay well, and I think he can run a big race. He does have a high weight here, but like I said, I think he'll. He's much the best here, and I think he'll run a big race. Before that, He ran the 10th of November at Aintree, 3 miles and 1/8 in a novice chase. He had one other rival that day, and, you know, he was just much the best. He won by 50 lengths, and, you know, it was just a walk in the park. He did, you know, no Chambon who rode the horse. It was like just taking out the horse for a walk. It doesn't get any easier than that. And then a Chepstow in a 3 mile novice chase back in October. He finished third by 28 lengths. That day, he just kind of weakened out of it a few from home. First off the break on yielding ground, he needed the run. And then at Galway on the 4th of August, 2 miles, 7/8 in a handicap hurdle. He finished second by 2 lengths. He jumped well, but, you know, he still needed that extra kick at the end. He ran okay. And then he ran in a handicap hurdle here at Punchestown on yielding ground last April, where he finished seventh by 5 lengths. He jumped okay, better than most of the horses there, but he still needed the improvement. Like I said, I like him going up to longer trip today. I think he wants it. He has a little bit of a refreshing. He's going to have the high weight, but like I said, he's much the best here, and he's faced a lot tougher horses than he's facing today, and I think he'll stay. So at 5-1, I'll take the shot with him. So to recap my selection for the second, the 3-10 from Punchestown Spoilsport Handicap Chase, let's go to the 2 horse Manila Awards, and we'll go 2-8 in the forecast exacta. Let's get to race number 3. The 350, the third race from Punchestown. It is the Grade 1 Irish Stallion Farm EBF Annie Power Mares Champion Hurdle. It's a Grade 1 race going for a purse of $115,500. Races for 4-year-olds and upwards. Mares only were EBF eligible. Field of 8 horses heading to post. A distance of ground of 4,000 meters or 2.5 miles over the hurdle course. My top selection, I'm going to use the one horse of Benidez Doe. And pardon me if I mispronounced the horse's name wrong. I just, you know, just pardon that, I can't speak English. I'm going to go 1-5 in the forecast exacta. 1-5 forecast exacta. Top selection, the one horse Benidez Doe. Again, just pardon that, I can't speak fucking English. Can't speak French either. This French-bred 8-year-old mare by a great pretender, Paul Towning, gets legger for Willie Mullins. The horse's most recent outing came at Cheltenham on the 12th of March, 2 miles and 1/2 in the Grade 1 OLBG Mares Hurdle. The horse didn't finish the race. He fell a few from home at 91 cents a dollar. It was a very heartbreaking fall for the favorite backers. Just couldn't get into it. It wasn't the day to win. Before that, back here at Punchestown back in last April, 2 miles and 1/2 in this race, the horse won by 3 lengths, and she put on a show at 3-1. She beat Apple's Jade, and she just went away with it. It was a very good run for this horse, and then before that, she ran at, what the fuck is that? Cat's on the TV over there, and he keeps, changing the channels. I don't know what the wrong with the cat is, but where was I? I think I was back up to Punchestown last year. You know, she won this race by 3 lengths. She beat Apple's Jade, very good run. Before that, she ran at the Festival of Cheltenham in 2018 on very heavy ground in the Grade 1 OLBG Mares Hurdle, which she won by 1/2 length, and there she beat Apple's Jade again. She went away with it. It was a very good run, and then she ran here over at Nace last February of 2018 in Mares Chase. She won by 2.5, and again, she stayed well. She's second off the break. Throughout the Cheltenham race, she should like the going, and I think she's your most likely winner on the card, I think, and probably your most likely winner of the week, I want to say. Out of all the horses this week I've handicapped, I think she's like I said, she's going to be much the best, and I think she's going to be on the major improve. Problem is, she's 1-5. There's not a lot of profit with her betting a win wager, so you'll have to go very heavy on the forecast and hope you win it. So here's my forecast for the third, the 350 from Punchestown to Grade 1 Mares Champion Hurdle. Let's go with the one horse, and we'll go 1-5 in the forecast exacta. And we'll have to play it quite a bit to make some money with this race. So now let's get to the fourth, the 425 from Punchestown. Excuse me, the fourth race, the 425, it is the Grade 1 AES Champion 4-year-old Hurdle. It's a Grade 1 race going for a purse of $115,500, races for 4-year-olds only. 6 horses are going to post, the distance of ground of 3,200 meters or 2 miles over the hurdle course. Top selection here, I'm going to go to the number 2 horse, Fakir de Ornares. Again, pardon me if I mispronounce a horse's name wrong. I'm going to go 2-3 in the forecast exacta. 2-3 forecast exacta. Top selection at 2 horse. 4-year-old gelding by Capguard. Mark Walsh gets leg up for Joseph O'Brien and John McManus, who What's this one? The horse's most recent outing came the 4th of April at Aintree, 2 miles and 1/8 in the Grade 1 4-year-old juvenile hurdle, Dunbar Anniversary 4-year-old juvenile hurdle, where he finished second by a neck behind Pentland's Hill. And this horse, he jumped well. He had a decent turn of foot. He just missed at the end, but he ran a good race. Before that, he ran at Sheldon in the Skybet Supreme Novice Hurdle, the 2-mile journey on soft ground. He finished 4th by 11 lengths against a 9-2 favorite. He just kind of didn't get up the hill well. He jumped during the main portion, but he didn't have the best to run, and it wasn't his day to win. And then at Cheltenham on preview day back in January, late January, 2 miles 1/8 in the Grade 2 JCB Triumph Trial Juvenile Hurdle, he won by a baker's dozen, 13 lengths, and he just, you know, stayed well and had a very good jumping victory. And then he broke the maiden over the hurdles at Cork in early January by 3.5 and went away with it. I like him a lot. You know, he's run 4 times under the care of Joseph O'Brien. Before that, he was running in France under a previous trainer, but since he's moved to Joseph O'Brien, he's really improved. I think he's run 3 very good races, 1 okay race. I think he's sitting on another good race not nearly as tough as Sheldon or Aintree, and I think he'd get away with it. So at 5-2, I'll take him. So to recount my selection for the 4th, 425 from Punchestown's Grade 1 AES Champions 4-year-old hurdle, gonna go with the 2-horse word go, 2-3 in the forecast exacta. Let's get to race number 5. The 5 o'clock, the 5th race from Punchestown. This is going to be your money-making race of the day. The 5 o'clock, the 5th, it's the Palmertown House Pat Taffy Handicap Chase. It's a handicap chase going for a purse of $69,000, race for 5-year-olds and upwards. Field of 11 horses going 3 miles and 1/16, the extended 3 miles over the chase course. My top selection, I'm going to go with the 9-horse Swing Bridge. I'm going to go 9-4 in the forecast exacta. 9-4-4. Forecast exacta, but to tell you the truth, any one of these two can win, so I might just do an exacta box here, or forecast box, but we'll talk about the both of them. But first, if I had to give you the top selection out of the both of them, it would be the 9-horse Swing Bridge. Jack Kennedy's on this one for Gordon Elliott, 11-year-old Gillum by Milan, so he's been around the block a few times. His most recent appearance came the 24th of April, which was last week at Perth in Scotland, 3 miles in a handicap chase. First off the break, he jumped well. He finished second by 3 lengths. He had a decent turn of foot. He stayed well. It was a very good comeback race. I think second off the break, coming back here, I think he'll run even better. Before that, he ran at Navan on the 8th of December on quite wet ground, good to soft yielding ground, 2 miles 3/4 in a handicap hurdle. He finished 16th by 38 lengths there, and over the smaller obstacles, he just never got into it. It wasn't his day to win. And then at Navan, 3 miles in a handicap chase, he finished 9th by 35 lengths. Low weight, the horses were much better than him, and he just didn't get into it. And then before that, handicap chase there on heavy, heavy ground, 3 miles November the 14th. He finished 5th by 6 3/4 lengths. He never got into it. Biggest question with him is, he likes running at Perth, but he does run good races outside of Perth, but is he a Perth horse? Because his last win came at Perth on the 26th of September in a 3-mile handicap chase, which he won by 4.5, and he went away with it. But like I said, he can run well outside of Perth, but I think coming here second off the break, a little given the ground today with some of the rain they're expecting, and I think he could get a piece of it. So at 8-1, I'll take the chance, along with the number 4 horse, Walk to Freedom. Robbie Powers on this one for Jessica Harrington, this 9-year-old villain by Arcardio. The horse's most recent outing came in 22nd of April, that's very high, 3 miles and 1/8 in a handicap chase. He finished 3rd by 5.5 lengths there, and he jumped well, had a little bit of a turn of foot. It wasn't improved off the race before it came at Cheltenham, 3 miles in the Grade 3 Pentemps Network Finale handicap hurdle, where the horse didn't finish. He pulled up out of it, very demanding ground, high weight, you know, just didn't do well there. You either handle Cheltenham or you don't. The horse didn't handle Sheldon. And then Leopardstown, 3 miles in a handicap hurdle, he finished 2nd by 3/4 length there. He jumped very well, he just missed at the end, but he ran a good effort. And then Navan, 2 miles and a half in a handicap hurdle, he finished 4th by 3 1/4 lengths. He got 4th, but I thought he jumped well there also. And then on the 25th of November in a 2 mile 9/16 handicap hurdle, he won by 2.5 and he stayed well. The 3 mile trip should suit him also, and I think at 6-1 he's another horse, he could definitely get a piece fit, so I'll take him here also. But to recount my selections now for the 5th, the 5 o'clock from Punchestown's Palmertown House Pat Taffy Handicap Chase, I'll use the 9-horse Swing Bridge, and I'll choose the 4-horse Walk to Freedom. I'll probably do a 9-4-4-9 exacta box here, and possibly in each way on both of them, but I'll definitely use them in the place pot if I would play it. So now let's get to race number 6 from Punchestown. The 535, the sixth race from Punchestown, is the Ballymore Handicap Hurdle. It's a handicap hurdle going for a purse of $115,500, races for four-year-olds and upwards. We have a field of 28 horses. The 26 through 28 are also eligible, so only 25 could go. The distance of ground of 4,000 meters or 2.5 miles over the hurdle course. Before I get to my top selection, because here in North America, here in America, United States, we use the tote system. Certain totes, you know, our tote system can't handle large fields of horses sometimes. So some of these races that we import from Europe, we can't bet on. So this race right here, we won't be able to bet on because our tote system can't handle the large fields. Certain bookmakers, I think you can, but I don't have any of them. I use ExpressBet and NairaBets. So, you know, if I wanted to bet this race, I would have to find a bookmaker or, you know, an ADW, like we call them here in America. And hopefully, they'll offer wagering on this race, but the ones I use, they just don't offer because the tote system can't handle the large field of horses. So this race, I'm just giving you out a tip. I can't bet it, but hopefully you can, because I really like this horse as a top selection, and he's my best bet of the day. Like I said, unfortunately I can't bet it, but my top selection is going to be the one horse, Mr. Adjudicator. I'm going to go 1-6 in the forecast exacta. 1-6 forecast exacta. My top selection to one horse, Mr. Adjudicator. This 5-year-old gelding by Camacho. Patrick Mullins gets the leg up for Willie Mullins. Like I said, he's my best bet of the day. His most recent outing, he ran crap, though, on the 23rd of April at Ferry House, 2 miles in a handicap hurdle. He didn't finish the race at 4-1. He pulled up out of it. He just couldn't keep up there. The ground was just maybe not to his liking. Before then, in the Grade 3 County Hurdle handicap hurdle, Sheldon, 2 miles 1/8, March the 15th, he finished 8th by 9 3/4 lengths there. And he faced a lot tougher horse. He never got into it. And then at Nace on the 10th of November, 2 miles in the Grade 3 Fishery Lane Hurdle, he finished 2nd by 11 lengths. He jumped well. He had a decent turn of foot. I thought he ran well. And then he ran a race here at Punchestown, the 4-year-old hurdle last year, where he finished 2nd by 3 lengths. He jumped well. That day, if he had the 2.5 miles, he definitely would have won, but he stayed well. It was a very good run. And then he ran the JCB Triumph Hurdle at Sheldon in 2018, going the 2 mile and 1 furlong trip. He finished 2nd by 1 3/4 lengths again. He jumped very well. He's going to like the 2.5 mile today for the first time, and I think he'll stay well. He should like the going. He's going to be the heavyweight here, but he's stepping down loads of class from his last few, and I think, like I said, a 15-1, I think he's loaded here. He's going to be my best bet of the day. Like I said, unfortunately, I can't bet on it, but like I said, I like him a lot, so hopefully you'll take him to the bank. So to recap my selection for the 6th, 535 from Punchestown to Ballymore, a handicap hurdle, let's go with the one horse, Mr. Adjudicator. I'll go 1-6 in the forecast exacta, 1-6, and like I said, the one horse is my best bet. So the 7th race here, the 610. It's a National Hunt bumper. I'm not going to give you a tip in this one because I'm just not a big fan of them, because these races could be very random. I'll watch it as a fan, but I'm not going to give you out a tip. And the 8th race, the 640, it's a charity race here. And, you know, it's just not a race I would give out a tip because it's, again, going to be a random race. It's a fun race to watch. I'm just not going to give you a tip. So with that being said, it's the end of the Punchestown Festival. And I had a lot of fun this year. Hopefully we'll hit a few winners today. Some of the days this week have been okay. Some of the races have been crap, mainly Thursday. Yesterday we had 2 winners, but they were a little bit too short prices. But hopefully we'll cash in today. So good luck to all. Please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5 for more selections for race courses around the world. And join me the rest of the year for some more previews and selections here on YouTube. Good luck, everybody.